Hey guys, this is Ryko for VGgameplay, and this is part 3 of my Super Metroid playthrough. Welcome back. If you've just joined us, we have just picked up the high jump boots, and we're on our way back to Brinstar to fight Kraid. I'm just going to check this room quickly. I believe this is one of the rooms where the temperature is too hot. Yeah. I didn't go to the room right of the save point we were just in because I'm pretty sure that is a corridor that I can't get through yet. I don't really want to go that way. That's a sort of return point from the other side of the map. I believe. Alright, it's my last super missile. Get me through. Pretty good that I got this spacer upgrade straight away. Where is it? You bomb here, don't you? Does this door only unlock on the way back? Yeah, I guess it does. Thought it was one of those doors that unlocked for killing all the enemies, but we'll get it on the way back then. Dear, I really need to be using my missiles at this point. I'm just spamming the shoot button. That was pretty awful. Oh wait, this is the way I need to go, isn't it? I get carried away, I get a bit confused. There's a save point up here, which we may as well go for. Just for completion's sake. But I think, I definitely need to go down. Okay. I do not need to bomb there, Dave. Could do with some super missiles, it'd make Kraid a lot easier. I'm not dodging all those. Now that pretty much is the size of Kraid in the original Metroid game, but it's not a reference I got the first time I played this, because this was the first Metroid game I played. Okay, I'll get my health back after that atrocious combat, and get my missiles back. I think I'm on 30? Yeah, do with a few more. I'm gonna leave that super missile only because it stops those things spawning. Yeah, this is it. Nice big skull. Alright. I don't know who that's meant to be. Just sitting there in the suit. That's just another bounty hunter. One more super missile. Come on, you were so generous last time. I should have taken it. There it is. Cool. So this should be a little easier with the spacer, so I don't have to be so precise hitting him in the eyes. See? Oh, but I do have to make sure I hit him in the bloody mouth. Straight up to the top. I got his hand in the way. Three super missiles. That's the quickest I've ever done. Kraid as well.
Wow.
And all I get is two super missiles as a pickup. That's insane. I've never done it that quickly. Maybe one day I will go for a speed run of Super Metroid. Probably a bit too late to say this, three parts in, but if you've never played this game before, you shouldn't be watching me. You absolutely should not be watching me. You should be playing it yourself. If you're having this game spoiled for you, then you are really missing out. To get a shot out. I'm trying to remember what the Y button does as I get attacked. So my X button is shoot, A is jump, B is sprint. I haven't used Y at all yet. There you go, that room is now open. There we go, that'll do. And there we go, one energy tank. I think that's the first time I realised you could shoot holes in the ceiling and in the walls to find secrets. Again, the game sort of tells you quite earlier on. Then on the map, if there's a dot in a room, there's an item there. So when you do first get into that room and you can't find anything, you still know there's something there. And without having to tell you a thing, the game is encouraging you to have a look for it. Whoop. So, I think I want to go back down to Norfair, really. Yes, I do. I like how more, she looks so much more beefy now. So I now can go into the high temperature rooms. Which is what we're going to do first. We'll go through that door then. Oh god. I'll use my charge beam a bit more as well. It's up here I want to go. Whip. There's no secret over there. I don't think there is. I like the heat haze effect. That's pretty cool. Not something I appreciated as a kid, but... Thank you. can't shoot through these walls. Can't actually hurt those guys at all yet, can I? Ugh, you need to move. Walzers and trousers. Oh, back in the lava. What a palaver. Ha 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 ha. Yep, that's about as funny, as exciting, and as outrageous as this playthrough is getting. Another save point. Oh, we do it. We're only 10 minutes in. Let's have some fun. Let's have a look around. Is it this way I want to come in? I don't think it is. Let's just find out. I may as well. I've started, so I'll finish. Oh, yeah. That'll do. It's my first missile upgrade for a while. It's here I need to go. Oh god. Just. I want to say down first. Nothing much here unless you want to farm for items. Not a term I ever used until I was growing up, farming. I think this is the way. Whoop. Ah, poop. Whoop. Bit slow on my jumping at the moment. Fortunately, I've got the health to fall back on. I think I can go anywhere here yet. I believe there's... Oh, maybe it isn't the spazer that goes through walls then. There's the... That is a door on the right hand side, on the bottom right hand side of the screen. Don't know what's going on there. Bit of a graphical glitch. This is where my platforming needs to improve. There we go, not too bad. Not too bad. Whip. What's over here? Oh yes, I know where we are. This is all a dead end, I believe. You. Yeah. So I need the grappling hook. Oh, get out of my way, little frog. Thank you. I need the grappling hook to get to the end of this room, but I believe there are some missiles partway in the room, so we're going to go for those first. I'm going to waste 5 missiles to increase my maximum. This bit's tricky. Thank you. There we go. And yeah, I definitely need the grappling hook. Is there another secret? I can't help but feel there's a secret in that screen, but maybe not. Maybe not. Nope, wrong weapon. Oh. It cost me a bit of health. That's probably the most obscure secret in the game, in this game, at least. Shooting that hole in the ceiling. At least the most obscure secret in which, you know, you need to know about it in order to complete the game. Here we go, the next big upgrade, the speed booster. Again, on my first playthrough, I think I didn't realize how to get back up. I didn't realize you had to use that ability straight away to clear this area, so I'm trying to jump over each of these platforms as fast as I can, and I'm getting caught in the lava and just getting angry. Getting angry because of my own stupidity. I would have only been about like 8 or 9 at the time, so I'll let myself off. But yeah. Do you think there's anything here? Don't have the grappling hook yet, so cannot get up to that top door. If I had the ice beam, that'd be doable. But I don't. So that's the way we came. I think we want to go back down, but through the left-hand door this time. So yeah, this is all new. Can't go this way yet, because I do not have the gun I thought I had. Whee. And here we go, we've done a full circle. From beginning to the end of the video, I have rejoined at the save point. So that'll be a good place to leave it for now. Thank you for watching. Hopefully I'll see you again in part 4. Take it easy.